In the middle of a cornfield near Providence, Kentucky, you'll find Rick Honaker. He's a mining engineering professor at the University of Kentucky, and he's running a test plant to extract rare earth elements from coal.
On a periodic table, they are typically the lanthanide series, which is a horizontal row at the bottom of the periodic table, plus scandium and yttrium.
From light bulbs to golf clubs, cell phones to electric vehicles, rare earth elements make an array of products.
You're looking at about a quarter ton of rare earths in one of those permanent magnets that's used to create energy by a windmill. There's about 5 kilograms of rare earths in every electric vehicle, and we expect electric vehicle production is going to exponentially increase. Almost doubling the amount of rare earths that's currently produced today would be needed in order to build all of these new electric vehicles. Probably 85 to 90% of the world's rare earths are produced in China, and the manufacturing of the material occurs primarily in China. The projections are that sometime in the 2025-2030 time period that China is going to stop being an exporter because of their thirst for the rare earths. In fact, they are buying up a lot of resource bases around the world, and that's certainly a concern for a lot of countries, U.S. being one of them. One of the most cited internationally coal sources is the fire clay seam. That seam is predominantly in eastern Kentucky. The reason why it's special is because it was during the time of formation, it was exposed to volcanic ash deposition. And that volcanic ash carried with it lots of valuable rare earths. With the funding that we've received from the U.S. Department of Energy, we've constructed a quarter ton an hour processing facility that will take multiple types of feedstocks, whether it's the actual acid water, the precipitate, or the actual parts of the coal in a solid form. It involves physical separations as well as chemical separations. So the first part of it is to actually put it in a form that's most amenable toward the leaching process. And then after we get it into solution, then we follow that up with how we can separate the rare earths out of the solution. In addition, the rare earths, we're after all other types of elements, for example, cobalt, vanadium, and rubidium, and other valuable elements that tend to be concentrated in coal. So we're looking at separating those out. We'll start off producing a concentrate mix, and we've been successful in the lab in a continuous form, actually producing a 99% pure rare earth product. So we'll be doing that, but we'll also be taking that one step further and actually producing rare earth concentrates. The end result is a technical economic feasibility study, and then we'll be using those results in another project that we have, which is looking at a small commercial scale plant. So we're in phase one of that project where we're designing what would be a 20 ton an hour system. And so if you can go to an industry that's already producing a product where rare earths could be a byproduct, and your mining costs and a lot of your processing costs are already covered, then it makes the economics a lot more favorable. We've developed a lot of intellectual property products from our research that focuses specifically on reducing costs. We've discovered ways that we can actually benefit from perhaps energy production simultaneously with the rare earth production that we're not currently exploiting. We've identified some chemistry in our process that makes it more amenable to recover rare earths. So from Kentucky's perspective, as coal being a major economic source in parts of our state, you know, providing a means of recovering an important byproduct adds economic strength and viability to the coal industries in those regions. I'm invited to give lectures at, you know, by the Department of Defense and, you know, by the Department of Energy and a number of other agencies and organization and companies, because they realize the importance of rare earths to manufacturing. And so just being involved in a project that is so meaningful, not only from a local community standpoint, but from a national, international standpoint, you know, when you do something, you announce the development, it makes international news. The team that we have out working on the pilot plant is a team of undergraduate students from not only mining engineering, but also chemical engineering. We have postdocs. So the training opportunities that we have is tremendous, because that's really what we're here for, is to educate and to develop technology, and nobody's ever done this before. You can't open up a book on rare earth recovery from coal or coal-based resources and discover a way of doing it. It's a brand new field, and we're learning on the fly. Starting with our first effort in 2014, we had no idea where we were going. But we went, and we went at a very fast pace, and we've been very successful, and that's been very satisfying.